When you think of placebos, you think sugar pills. But what if surgery can be a placebo as well? When surgeries were first used, their sole purpose was to save lives. So it was pretty obvious when operations worked as intended and when they didn't. But today, we've developed procedures that aren't designed to save patients, but to improve quality of life, opening the door to a whole new kind of surgery that might take advantage of the placebo effect. The placebo effect we've talked about a lot. It's the idea that you feel better because you got some kind of medical attention, even if that isn't necessarily medical treatment. The classic example is the administration of a sugar pill instead of a drug. Even though there was no drug involved, patients will sometimes report that they feel better and can walk away cured. It may be hard to think of a surgery as just a placebo because, after all, when you go under the knife, you're going under the knife. A surgeon is actually doing something. They're slicing and dicing. But it turns out, because surgery is so serious and there's all this prep involved, many have the mindset that if it's surgery, it's meaningful. And that's exactly what makes surgery a great placebo. In fact, studies on the placebo effect found that invasive surgery has a stronger effect than non-invasive surgery. Injections are better than sugar pills, which may help explain why procedures like acupuncture will sometimes test as no more effective than a placebo. One researcher wrote that injections, quote, seem to associate with higher placebo effects and more magic. They test this by performing both real and sham surgeries on test subjects. A sham surgery is a procedure designed to make the patient think they're having the real operation, but no real treatment is done. There are real surgeries done every year that test as no better than a placebo. One of these is arthroscopic surgery for osteoarthritis of the knee. 692,000 were performed in 2010. Patients who undergo these treatments usually report feeling better afterward, even if they were only given the sham surgery. And that's not the only one. A vertebroplasty, where cracked vertebrae are filled in with bone cement to alleviate back pain, and percutaneous myocardial laser revascularization were both tested against placebos and found no more effective than shams. The placebo illusion is even more convincing when patients can watch a live feed of their operation and have a little souvenir scar when it's all over. Before the pretend surgeries were shown to be placebos, hundreds of thousands of people in the US had them done each year at a cost of billions of dollars. So now that we have evidence that they might not work, is it ethical to keep doing them? Is it ethical to trick people into thinking they got effective surgery if they didn't? It's a tough cookie either way you slice it. And the kicker is, there are even ethical problems with testing surgeries against a placebo in the first place. It's hard to do a double-blind study on surgery where both the patient and surgeon have no idea if they're administering a treatment or a placebo, because usually the surgeon knows if they cut you up or not, right? There are examples, but the ethics are closely watched. Drugs have to prove they're more effective than a placebo in order to be approved by the Food and Drug Administration. But a 2014 systematic review of almost 3,000 surgical trials found only 53 were tested against sham operations. Again, because of ethics. Sham surgeries can help determine if a procedure is actually doing something, but anytime you slice into someone, you're introducing a lot more risk than there is in a sugar pill, especially if anesthesia is involved. On the other hand, if a surgery was widespread but later was proved ineffective, then didn't performing all those operations expose more people to risk than if a small trial had the placebo option in the first place? Placebo surgery is a tough question that the medical community is still grappling with today. And regardless, it looks like you can chalk up one more big win for the placebo effect. Fun fact, before arthroscopic knee surgery was shown to be as effective as a placebo, it was the most common orthopedic procedure in the United States. For more on crazy surgeries, how about a full body transplant, what some people call a head transplant? Check out why it's a bad idea in Crystal's video here. Thanks for watching, Seeker. Please subscribe, and we'll see you next time.